And enterprise vulnerability has public exploits. Big brands are going passwordless. And install this Android security patch ASAP. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for May 10th, 2022. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. I have an announcement. I have a new Patreon perk to share with y'all. You know how I always cover about three headline stories on the show? Well, now Patreon supporters will be able to listen to a fourth story, which is an exclusive, over on the Patreon page. The link to support and get access to perks is down in the description right down below. And now on to the first news story. A vulnerability tracked as CVE-2022-1388 is being exploited to drop malicious payloads on several different versions of F5 Big IP modules. Now, this was first made publicly known last week when F5 disclosed the remote code execution flaw, and they told administrators to update to the newest security updates to patch it. The problem resides in the Big IP iControl REST authentication component, wherein an attacker could bypass any authentications usually required to execute malicious commands on a vulnerable F5 device with elevated privileges. Now, according to F5, quote, "This vulnerability may allow an unauthenticated attacker with network access to the Big IP system through the management port and/or self IP addresses to execute arbitrary system commands, create or delete files, or disable services. There is no data plane exposure. This is a control plane issue only. And while this problem only affects that management side of these devices, which should not be exposed to the internets, some still are. In fact, Rapid7 security researcher Jacob Baines did a scan and he found 2,500 exposed. F5 is a cloud security and application delivery network, or an ADN, and their Big IP products are commonly used in enterprise networks. Several different groups of security researchers were able to create working exploits within days based on the mitigation information that F5 posted. And since it's trivial to do so, a series of warnings were shared on social media across Twitter, for example, and across security networks to update devices ASAP. With exploits now being leaked online just shortly after and made available publicly, anybody could use these. So patch immediately, and if you can't update, block all access to the iControl REST interface through self IP addresses, set up restrictions for access to only include users and devices through that management interface, and modify the Big IP HTTPD config. Passwordless authentication is coming soon to a device near you. Apple, Microsoft, and Google will be introducing passwordless authentication, which will allow users to sign in across multiple devices and websites in a more seamless experience, and it will increase security at the same time. Support will be coming to Google's Android and Chrome web browser, Apple's iOS, macOS, and Safari, and Windows Edge browser plus their operating system. The standard, which is developed by the World Wide Web Consortium, or the W3C, and the FIDO Alliance, is another step towards helping users be more secure online while offering an easier approach for convenience. Now, this will work via the protocol which is called Fast Identity Online, or FIDO for short, which can allow a user to unlock their phone to sign into a website or an application on their computer instead of requiring a password. A prompt will be displayed on the computer's browser, for example, telling you to check your phone and requiring you to unlock your phone, which can be done like you normally would do every single day by using your thumbprint, a face unlock action, or a PIN code, for example, on your phone. Your phone will be sent a prompt to verify that it's you by unlocking. FIDO works by storing a cryptographically secured passkey on a phone, and that is used to authenticate a user to an account after you successfully unlock your phone. After that happens, you don't need to unlock your accounts again. You can just unlock them by unlocking your computer. Now, you may be wondering what happens if your phone is stolen or it's lost. Well, your passkey can be synced to a new phone from a cloud backup. This can also allow for cross-platform compatibility. So for example, Microsoft explained in their own blog post that you could sign into Google Chrome on a Windows PC by using a passkey on an iPhone. This also means that you would not have to re-enroll every single account you log into on every device. And how is this more secure than passwords? Well, phishing is a serious problem, as is password reuse. So removing passwords altogether helps remove that factor as a potential vulnerability. Also, legacy 2FA like SMS is still overused, and SMS can also be phished. In this format, the phone needs to be within proximity of a PC or a laptop that a user is trying to log into, potentially defeating the possibility of a remote attacker stealing your phone and using it to sign in. The authenticating device also checks to make sure the URL is legitimate and not a phishing website. Obviously, local attacks could still happen if an attacker somehow gained access to your phone and used a PIN, not a biometric, to unlock it. Now, the three companies are planning to implement this within the next year, but developers of websites and applications will also have to adopt and implement this feature as well. Real quick, I want to say a big shout out to my Hush Puppy Perk level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos, or in this case, a feather baby video. Oh my gosh, it's my first fur feather baby video for ThreatWire, and that just makes me so happy. And thank you so much for the support. A huge thank you to CypherKnot as well for joining the Alliance on patreon.com/threatwire. We officially have over 800 Patreon Alliance members. That's crazy to me. And all of them get access to a fourth news story every single week. So check that out if you are interested. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story. This one's about a Linux kernel vulnerability. Now, an Android kernel vulnerability was just patched by Google, so make sure to update your devices because this one is being actively exploited. Google's Android is built on Linux, and since Android is using this modified Linux kernel, it's also affected by this privilege escalation issue that could allow a local attacker with access to the device to exploit the flaw. It's tracked as CVE-2021-22600, and this was originally disclosed back in January by Google's own researchers to Linux vendors, along with a fix. But Android has just put out their own patch this month. Now, Linux distros like Debian, Red Hat, Ubuntu, they all patched the issue back in December to January 2022, that time frame. It's a double free vulnerability existing within the packet network protocol implementation of the Linux kernel. Flaws like this can cause memory corruption, denial of service, or arbitrary code executions. Now, Google has stated via their May Android Security Bulletin that it may be under limited targeted exploitation. And CISA, they also stated that it was being actively exploited back in April. Android 9 users should update to a newer operating system if possible so that they can also get access to these patches as well. Do you want to see more tech videos from me? Check out my YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/Shannon Morse, just like my name is spelled, for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. And with that, do not forget to like and subscribe to Hack5. I'm Shannon Morse, and I'll see you on the internet.